how do you go about starting a label?
Let's say what you're paying for today as an artist to a record label, like the collaborations you do today, is not the same as it used to be, because we've kind of moved away from physical mediums. So yeah. You're not buying CDs or cassette tapes that much anymore. Vinyls has a resurgence for sure, but it's not that common. You know, most labels now are primarily digital.
Yeah.
And that's what the record labels back in the day, that's the power they had, the power of distribution. That's what you would sign on for, because you couldn't distribute it yourself. It was impossible. Two, you pay for marketing. Marketing and connections, that's why you decide to collaborate with a record label.
Okay. But how do you actually start it? When you started Blindfold, how did you go about it? Like, how do you go about starting your very own label?
We researched. You can search online and say, how do I get my music on Spotify?
Yeah.
And there's kind of two ways. There's one where it's direct artist to platform via an aggregator. That's what they call them.
Yeah.
It could be CD Baby or something similar. But for us, we kind of looked for who can we partner up with that's meant for record labels, so no bulk. Instead of one release a year, maybe we're going to do a lot more. So we were kind of looking at deals, what were they, all of them kind of giving us, and what would we prefer to get. So we kind of asked actually other artists that had record labels and said, who are you with and do you like them and what's good, what's bad? So we researched the market, one. Yeah. Two, we found out, okay, this guy we kind of trust. It seems like he's a pretty decent guy. We found a one person company, basically.
Okay.
And what he provided was he would handle contracts for us. I did do our own contracts, but I gave them to him, and then he could kind of do like digital contract signing for me. We also outsourced to him. He's getting a higher cut than we would get without it, but he's handling royalty statements, for instance.
Yeah.
So I sent him expense sheets for each release and say, this is the amount of expenses we had. And then he'll sort it out for me. So he'll send every year, say, here's the statements for the artist. You can just email them out now.
Okay.
Which is probably today is one of the most annoying admin tasks you can get. And that's actually one of the reasons why we chose that distributor. That was the reason for it.
Okay, yeah.
But yeah, good, bad deal, I'd say. It's difficult to say because it depends on how big it is, because some of them have direct deals and some of them don't. So it's kind of hard to say.
What would you think the most important thing is to focus on when you're starting a label is?
Having the right partners in place.
Yeah.
Getting the best possible team. Because you can say today a record label is a curator of music, at least in electronic music we work with. Most of them are boutique labels, meaning they are focused on quite a small niche. Can be the same sound or similar sound. You have to find someone who also likes that. Otherwise, it's going to be difficult to kind of collaborate.
Yeah.
Two, you're a marketing company. You're going to want to create media stuff. So you're going to be making artwork. You're going to be making videos. You're going to be taking pictures. All this is content that needs to be created. You need to have someone who's able to do that. Otherwise, you'll be poor very quickly. So it won't be possible for you to actually be profitable unless you can find someone who can do it either dirt cheap, or you can find someone who will be part owner and do that work for you.
Okay.
Yeah. So you need the right skills, kind of. Yeah.
You need to assemble a team or find people to work with that.
Yeah. So one, you need an admin guy who's kind of like has basic knowledge of how do we make a contract? How do we do basic transactions? What do we do? How do we send invoices? Stuff like that.
Yeah.
I learned that on the go. So, and that I think most people should just try and see what happens. I don't think it's not that difficult. You need someone to do media stuff for you. You need someone who can write press releases and write emails to people, because if you want to promote something, most of it is primarily by networking, either via Facebook or email. So your network is quite important. So if you can find someone who already has a network that's super strong, that's very important too. Or artists have connections to other artists. So if you want to release music, starting out is super difficult, because who wants to sign a track to a label that has no releases.
Yeah.
That's the most difficult part, actually. That is finding, one, music that you think is good enough, and two, artist is actually willing to release with you, even though they know you're a rookie.